What role does power electronics play in electric vehicles? This is Pierre and Malia, two second-year students at UT Lyon, specializing in electrical engineering and industrial IT. After their exams, they decide to spend a weekend in the Beaujolais. 2 days of hiking, lakes, and barbecues. For the trip, Pierre borrows his parents' car, a small electric city car, perfect for the journey. The car has a 400-volt DC battery, fitted with power electronics. These devices will be at work when the car is charging, on the road, and even once they've arrived at their destination. And that's what we're going to look at. Why is power electronics needed to recharge an electric vehicle? Before leaving for the weekend, Pierre needs to charge the car. At home, he has two options. Either his parents have installed a 3 kilovolt amps single-phase charging station without power electronics, connected directly to the grid, or they haven't done so, and he'll use the standard sockets in his garage, 230 volt 16 amp, and the cable provided with the car. In both cases, he has a problem. The sockets, or the charging station, both provide between 120 volts and 230 volts, but the battery functions at a 400 volt DC voltage. So, we'll install a charger in the car, connected to the battery. It includes a number of power electronics devices, including a rectifier, which will transform the incoming alternating current into direct current, and a boost converter, which will increase the voltage of the incoming current. What is power electronics used for when driving? Once the car is charged, Pierre hits the road to go pick up Malia. The car's wheels are powered by an alternating current electric motor. But remember, it's not the same alternating current as our electrical network at 50 Hz. To operate, the motor needs an alternating current, the waveforms of which are adapted to the required rotational speed and torque. These are known as sinusoidal waves. However, the battery always supplies direct current. An inverter is therefore placed between the battery and the motor. This transforms the direct current from the battery into alternating current suited to the motor. This inverter is bidirectional, i.e., it enables current to flow in both directions. For example, this makes it possible to display the motor's power level or send power back to the battery when we take our foot off the accelerator or when the brakes are gently applied. This system is referred to as battery regeneration and, among other benefits, provides greater battery life. How does power electronics work in the vehicle's electrical equipment? Pierre and his friends have hit the road. Malia, turn some music on. The windows are rolled down. The trip is off to a great start. The car radio and the switches to open and close the windows are all electrical equipment built into the car. So are the buttons on the dashboard, the heater, etc. But most of this equipment operates on a 12-volt circuit and wouldn't be able to withstand the 400 volts supplied by the battery. A chopper is therefore placed between the battery and the equipment. The chopper will be isolated in order to separate the circuit in the passenger compartment at 12 volt from that of the battery at 400 volt. This isolation is mainly for safety reasons. Contact with the 400 volt circuit would be fatal. How can we protect vehicles from electromagnetic fields? All the electronic equipment in Pierre's car generates electromagnetic fields, but can also be sensitive to electromagnetic fields generated externally. Very high voltage cables or certain industries, such as aluminium hydrolysis sites, etc. These electromagnetic fields can cause certain equipment to malfunction. For example, all the windows might open or close unexpectedly, or worse, the car might start accelerating all by itself. To avoid these problems, metal casings and sheaths are installed around each wire and system. How can a car battery power both the vehicle's equipment and external electrical devices? Once they've arrived, the party can get started. The electric car has got the group safely to their destination. But its work doesn't end there. In the past, onboard car chargers were unidirectional, meaning the current flowed in one direction only, from the generator to the battery. Today, more and more chargers are bidirectional, the battery becomes a generator, which can power electrical devices outside the car. For example, a small city car has a 42 kilowatt-hour battery. It can charge music speakers. Each speaker requires 60 watts of energy. Or power an electric cooler, which requires around 50 watts. Perfect for always having a cool drink on hand.